Hi everyone, Michelle Fixit here today. Today we are going to be working on getting this room ready to be able to paint it. So I've purchased some construction paper, not the stuff that you bring to a classroom, but the actual construction paper that comes in a roll. There is nameplate there in case you weren't aware that construction paper for schools, for children, is based off of cut up pieces of construction paper for painting rooms or protecting flooring while you're working on a project, in case you guys didn't know. I also have some painter's tape, and so we're gonna go around the perimeter of the room and get the construction paper on the floor, and the painter's tape will adhere for nice sharp corners and such. So, come with me as I work on getting the room squared up for paint and caulky and a lot of stuff. So this is my handy dandy roll of construction paper and my log of tape. So let's get this started. And we're going to close the door so our furry friend does not come in. So the way I like to get a room ready for paint, if I'm using this method, because this room will require substantial caulking, it will require the baseboards to be repainted, the door trim, the walls, and the ceiling. So I'm going to start my tape, and I'm going to go around the room with the tape, and then after the tape is initially on the floor, then I'm going to get my construction paper and adhere more tape to the construction paper so that way I know everything is properly seated and it's all stuck together. That's my method. If you have a different method, feel free to add it to the comments. So I just tear pieces. I know there are fancy people out there that have nice little videos. I also have to get something to dust with. I like using an old paintbrush. I'm not sure if I can find one, but we'll see. All right, so I was able to find a paintbrush, an old paintbrush, and a little thing to pick up some of the yuck and get you guys scrolled down a little bit. That way you can see what I'm doing. And I'm sure there's going to be lots of people that are like, Gerber Cottage, you can do it this way. And there's those fancy people on TikTok, and they just have that roll and everything else. But you know what? This is more of just a common sense. So what I like to do when I have to repaint a room is I scrub everything down before I paint, because if it's a rental or if it hasn't been painted in a while, you never know what kind of stuff is in here. And as I'm going around the baseboard, I'm trying to make sure that I get any yuck out of here. It could be on the top of the baseboard or the bottom of the baseboard. So I'm doing the top, I'm doing the bottom, as I have little piles. Turn into sky. Power cords going. And of course, before you do all this, you would have wanted to sweep out the room. And it's already been swept with the broom. But using a paintbrush and doing the hands and knee thing just seems to work better. And it does work pretty well. We're going to start with an L just for the sake of people wanting to watch the short video. Because if you guys haven't noticed, I make videos that are actually working on it. I don't edit. It's me working. And, you know, the tripod gets shuffled around and everything else. And please, please, I'll do the landlord special, which I'm sure I'll get accused of for different videos. Take your outlet covers off.
just so we do not do it. All right. So, there you go. On my first piece of tape. As you can tell, this door frame is all messed up. I'm going to have to adhere it, do a bunch of work to it. But in anticipation of that, I'm still going to tape. If you can put your tape underneath the door frame, do that. If you want it to be nice and tidy, you can caulk around the bottom of it if you do have that play. And then when you paint, you can paint it, and then you're going to score it out with a razor blade before you pull that tape out, and that way everything will be sharp and crisp. Don't be sloppy. And then you're going to get your tape as close to the lines as possible. If you are a lady and you are doing this, or if you have nails, you can use your nails to dig right into that and then just make sure everything looks better. I like doing sections, it's easier to control. I overlap by half an inch to an inch. You'll see videos where they're fast and they just boom, boom, boom. But here's the thing. If you're not a professional, you do what you need to do to make it look good for you. Take the extra time. Watch those videos of the guy just going around the room. That's his job. If your job is to be a professional at taping, and you can do it at a faster rate, or maybe you do it at a faster rate and you don't care what the product looks like. So I'm re-pulling this up because I actually had a little bit of overlap on my quarter around and I was not happy about that. Since we're having the nails works out really well. But you're not going to be as fast as a pro because you are not a pro. And if you are a pro, and this is all you do, then, you know, give me some helpful hints. Don't be a pooper. Alright, so that line is almost ready. When you get to the corners, like I said, that's a movie guy. When you get to the corners, you are going to want a sharp line. I'll show you how to do that. Again, I have nails. I'm just digging that in, making sure I have a sharp line. What in the world? So, I have lots of people that want to talk to me, clearly. Shell Fix It is working. Alright, so tucking that down, and then I actually bend the tape down a little bit. And then since I know that that is a sharp line, I'm going to adhere the tape right there. And that will turn it free. Even though for some reason part of that quarter round has been dug out. I don't know. I didn't do it. And I just do it in an arm length section. You can do it faster than me. And if you want to. That phone's coming up. If you want to grab something, you know how fast you were and how slow I am and how boring my stuff is. I'm cool with that. I'm just sharing what I'm doing. In case there's somebody out there who wants to watch a video of it. I gotta do this regardless. You guys are just a secondary thought. And I don't know if you guys can tell, but like all this This is why I'm talking. Because all these little lines and stuff, it's where the paint has just separated. It just looks bad. Do a little bit more because the cups are bigger. Check my phone. Alright. Camera at proper. So we're gonna grab construction paper. And our handy dandy knife. Score right here, so I'll take that as a spider runs across the floor. Taping on tape. And this doesn't have to be precise. So now that you've taped your precision lines, you can retape here. Or you can do this the first time. I prefer to have two lines. That way I know I'm only focusing on the sharp crisp lines at the beginning stage. I can just make more sense to me. Yes, it's a waste of product, it's a waste of money, but you know what? I can waste my money on what I need to waste my money on. Because that's all yucked up over there. Which is fine. Because I'm not going to add to that yuck, but I will be having to clean that yuck up. If I had appropriate tools, then I would be doing that right now. So putting my tape underneath door casing. If you can't, then you tape to the best of your abilities. Brush out any yuck that's in the cereal. Get as close as you can in that corner. If you have excess, bend it over. Then create your next line for that corner. You have a puppy that wants to get in here while you're doing all this. And they're still right here. There's space. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a sharp line with my razor blade. This little corner. And I'm going to stick that in there. And then I'm going to press it because I have long nails to be able to do things like that. All right. So we can continue with this. Fold this over. People were trying to do lots of different random things in here. do occasionally have people paint with me, so that is one of the reasons I'm over taping and going through this whole process, because I can paint without a drop cloth or any of the different stuff, but if I'm going to get this house done in a reasonable amount of time, I require plumbers. So I am going to make sure that they have a good work area so that I don't end up getting grumpy about paint on the floor or paint wherever. And before you say, oh, that's why you need to hire professional painters. I have hired professional painters before, and they have made messes. And I'm a DIYer, and I like teaching people how to DIY and giving them the opportunity to learn skills. So, grump at me all you want to. Projects just require a little bit of knowledge, a little bit of patience. This is one of them. Actually, I can get back into the tall tape strip thing right here. Yes, I could cut it and do all sorts of stuff. No, I'm just going to make sure it's not a big deal to me. Some days gonna trip over this, so then we'll paste more tape. Okay. are worried about people going a little too fast and messing your stuff up, just do this. It's better. If I paint by myself, I just forgot the drop cloth. Not really too concerned.
That will entertain me later. Because I messed that tape up. Alright, so we're gonna do our last rows. We're gonna go back over there. Then we'll do that strip right there in the middle. The tape is going under the floor around it. That's just ridiculous. And this is right here. bed bugs. I'm okay, Thor. Closet.
bit. So, our floor is now ready for paint. Well, our room is currently ready for paint. We're just gonna come in stages because I have to patch holes over here. It's a patch hole over here. I've gotta get an appropriate cover for that weirdness. I'm gonna take that shelf off. That's gotta come off. Of course, all the outlets and the light switch. I took my smoke alarm, so I gotta put that back in, and we're gonna be getting another fixture. So yeah, that's it. It takes time. So you guys like and subscribe. Have a fantastic day. I will see you next time. Lots of random how-to videos. So you guys have a great day. Bye!